Stock Options Trading, by www.optionstradingeducation.com. The stock options trading news these days is that puts on LinkedIn are expensive, twice that of call options on the newly released stock. LinkedIn was in the news last week as it went public. An issue before the IPO and now is LinkedIn employee stock options. Employee stock options at LinkedIn amount to nearly one-fifth of the value of the company. Stock option trading just started on LinkedIn as a company that goes public must trade for several days before becoming available for options stock options trading. The high cost of buying puts on LinkedIn may well be related to the issue of the large number of employee stock options at the company or the fact that LinkedIn doubled in price the first date of issue. When puts are popular, it tells us that options buyers believe there is a strong possibility of the stock price falling. When premiums are high on puts, it tells us that options sellers believe the same thing and want to be compensated for the risk they are taking when writing options on a stock. When to buy puts on stocks like LinkedIn is when the trader believes that the stock price is likely to fall. However, the price of the option, its premium, is important. Over time, options writers tend to make more money than options sellers because they price options according to the risk they are taking. If a trader buys puts in stock options trading, he does so after careful analysis of the strengths and weaknesses of a company and evaluation of market sentiment. When a new, popular stock hits the street, investors can get carried away and keep buying even when the stock price rises too high to support the logic of their purchases. Usually this is when investors believe that the stock has huge growth potential and that it will continue to rise. In stock options trading, a trader buys puts in the situation in the belief that the stock will correct. Another reason for buying puts in stock options trading is to protect profits. For example, investors who purchased LinkedIn at the IPO price of $45 now hold a stock that is selling at just below $90 a share. They may well believe that the company will continue to grow and that the stock price will continue to rise. However, they may believe that the stock is overpriced today. How to trade stock options in this case is to buy puts on the stock. If the stock continues to rise, the investor will simply have paid for a little insurance but will benefit from the rise in stock price. If the price falls substantially, the investor will be able to sell at the contract price, the strike price, even if the fall in price is dramatic. He will execute the contract and sell the stock, or he will simply execute the opposite trade and pocket the money. In the first case, he is out of the stock and can either buy again or can keep his money. In the second case, he keeps the stock at the lower price and has money. For more insights and useful information regarding options and options trading, visit www.optionstradingeducation.com.